It was announced on Wednesday that Vice President Harris will be heading to the El Paso area of the border. It's a very Democratic area, and already some critics have said that she should go a little bit further south where there is more border activity. It will be interesting to see how she handles it, because there could not be more attention on this moment, because the Vice President and the White House broadly have resisted sending either Harris or President Biden to the border. And this has become a big controversy for the White House. One of the challenges Harris has is obviously there's a lot of politics around this. And in particular, she heads down to the border less than a week prior to former President Donald Trump's trip to the border. He will be heading down there with a group of Republicans and speaking likely about immigration and a range of other issues. But he is already claiming credit for Kamala Harris's decision to go to the border, because he and the Republican Party as a whole have basically elevated Harris as the face of the Biden administration's immigration policy, and charged that Harris's and Biden's refusal to visit the border suggests that they are absent on what they describe as a crisis at the border. Harris is in a bit of a no-win situation, partly because it's taken her so long to visit, but also it's tough to say, you know, going down for half a day, that it is more than a photo op. She likely won't have any new policies to announce, and that's what a lot of advocates are looking for, reformed policies in the area or greater border enforcement in the area. And so, you know, it really just depends on how she handles this visit, if it's seen as a success and a real reflection that the Biden administration is taking it seriously.